Hey, what's up guys, this is Nair Sheikh from blogdude.com, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to create the best ever e-commerce website using WordPress. But why do I call it the best ever e-commerce website? This is because of three basic reasons. First, because in this video we'll see how to create the perfect e-commerce website without using any code whatsoever. So even if you don't know anything about WordPress, by the end of this video you will be an expert in WordPress. Secondly, because this video is a one-stop solution for all your problems and queries related to WordPress. And thirdly, because in this video we'll be using the best and the most effective features which you only find in giant corporations like Amazon, Walmart and Flipkart. Let's see some of them. So this is the website which we'll be creating in this particular tutorial. So as you can see, this website is beautiful. It's super professional, super awesome. We are selling different products, we have different sections. We have taken inspiration from the top brands, from the top e-commerce brands. Let's see some of them. For example, as you can see, this is Flipkart. Flipkart is the number one e-commerce platform in India. In Flipkart, they have a small slider at the top. Even in Amazon, they have the same. So for our website also, we have a small slider, okay? Then when we scroll down, we see Flipkart is divided into different sections selling different products. Same here in Amazon, divided into different sections. So similarly for our website also, we have divided the website in different sections. For example, this is the first section which is showing three different categories. This is the second section which says the bestseller. Third section, ads. Fourth section, we have some tabs which shows different categories with different products. Then we have some brand names and a blog, last three blogs. So I'll show you how to create a blog, how to create different blogs. We have a small gallery over here. We have also some icons to beautify the website, saying the features, for example, free delivery and so on. I'll also show you how to create a newsletter and link it to MailChimp so that you can send newsletters to your users, to your visitors who subscribe to you through their email address. Okay, we have so many different and amazing features in this website. Let me show you some of them. For example, we have sales countdown. What is a sales countdown? Let's open this product and see. For example, as you can see, this product, below the product we have a counter going on. For example, it says 293 days and so on. So suppose you say you're giving some discount on a product for a limited period of time, you can view or show the counter over here for that period of time. So this is a sales countdown. We also have a feature called share for discount. Let me show you what is that. Let's open this product and see what a share for discount is. Basically, a share for discount is given when you want users or visitors to share your product, or your website with their friends and family. So when they share your product, they get a discount. This helps you in social marketing. For example, this product is worth a $149. So let's see, let's like the page and see what happens. As you can see, it will ask you the login address and so on. When you log in and like the page, you'll get the discount over here. So this was the share for discount feature. We also have another feature, a very beautiful, a very premium feature, which is a in stock alert. Many a times we see that the product is out of stock and we don't know when the product will be in stock. So this feature is for that situation. So this product is showing out of stock and we are getting an option, email me when this product is back in stock. So when we click on this, we get a pop-up. And when we fill in this pop-up, we'll get an email when this stock is back, when the product is back in stock. So this is the website we'll be creating. I'll show you how to create different pages like the contact us page, the about us page. I'll show you how to create different products, how to make your website a successful website, your e-commerce a successful platform. I'll also show you how to enter these features like filter by price, filter by color. Basically, I'll teach you everything you want to know about e-commerce, and I hope you guys are interested. If so, let's get started. To create any website, whether it be an e-commerce website, a social network website, or any kind of website, we need two basic things: a domain name and a hosting plan. For both domain name and hosting plan, I prefer HostGator. You'll see a link in the video description below. When you click on that link, it will redirect you to HostGator. So don't forget to click on that link. Or even you can do one thing, type in blogdude.com/HostGator in your URL, and it will redirect you to the HostGator shared plans page. That is very important page. As you can see, it has redirected us to the shared plan page. HostGator basically gives three plans: hatchling plan, baby plan, and business plan. And I prefer, most of the web developers prefer the baby plan because it is more suitable for the website. So if you also prefer the same plan, you can choose any plan, obviously, but baby plan gives you unlimited domains, so we basically prefer the baby plan. So click on sign up now. Once we click on sign up now, we'll be redirected to this particular page. Here you have to choose the domain name for your website, whatever domain name you prefer for your website. I'm putting blogdude.com. Okay, you can put in your choice domain name. It says it is unavailable, but it is also giving me some different recommendation like blogdude.online, blogdude.site, but I want the blogdude.com, which is already registered. I have registered. So once if you already have a domain, you click over here, I already own this domain, then we can proceed. Then here we have to choose the hosting plan. We have already selected the baby plan. Make sure baby plan is selected. And now we have to select the billing cycle: 1 month, 6 month, 12 month. It's all up to you. I prefer the 12 month plan. You can choose any username you want. For example, Nayur Sheikh, I'm choosing. It's all up to you. Any security pin, 4 to 8 digit number. So let's check some simple thing: 1, 2, 3, 4. Fill in your billing address, for example, billing info, for example, your email address, first name, last name, company name, phone number, address, all basic things. Your credit card or debit card information, the card through which you want to make the payment. You can also make the payment or purchase the hosting plan with PayPal, so it's all up to you. So once you do that, come down, we see some additional services. First is the hack alert monitoring. We basically don't need all these things, so untick both this thing and make sure everything is unticked over here. Now let's come down. We have something called enter a coupon code. So what you have to do is just enter a coupon code, which is webdude45. The spelling is given in the video description below. It's webdude45. When you put in this coupon code, you get a bigger discount, a higher discount. Okay, so as you can see, we are getting a bigger discount. Once you are done with this, just click on here, tick mark. I have read and agreed to the terms and conditions. And at the final step, you just have to click on the checkout now. Okay guys, so once you click on checkout now, you will get an email from HostGator. Let's open this email and see how it looks like. Okay guys, so this is how your email will look like. It is very important email. Make sure you save this information somewhere in your computer or anywhere you want. It has got many important information like your control panel link, your username, domain name, password, your name, servers, and so on. So what we have to do is just open the control panel link in a new tab. Let's open this in a new tab and put in your username and password. You will get it over here, your username and password. Just copy and paste it over here and click on login. Okay guys, so this is our control panel. This is our backend of the website of the hosting plan we are using. As you can see, we have so many different options, so many different features, but we are dealing with the WordPress. So just click on over here in the popular link, WordPress one-click installation. This step will install WordPress on the domain name which we have chosen. Okay, so from your choosing your domain name, the domain name for on which you want to install the WordPress. Okay, so this is the domain name which I am using, and make sure the directory thing is empty. Don't put anything over here. Now click on next. Now You can put in the blog title, anything. For example, we are putting e-commerce website. Okay, admin user, I'm putting Nayar, first name Nayar, last name Sheikh. Your email address, I'm putting my email address, you put your email address, and tick mark this terms of service agreement. After you do this, just click on install now. So WordPress is installing. Okay, it says installation complete. Basically WordPress is installed on our website. Let's open our website in a new page, in a new tab. Okay, fine. So WordPress is successfully installed on our website. Okay, so what we have to do is just click on your here, and after the URL of your website, just put in /wp-admin. Okay, /wp-admin and press enter. You'll see this. Okay, so from here, copy your username and your password and paste it over here and click on login. Okay guys, so basically WordPress is installed on our website. The first thing what we have to do is change the password, because as you can see, we got an ugly password, very hard to remember from HostGator. We want our own password. So however, here and click on edit my profile. Make sure you're following my cursor so that you don't get confused what I'm talking about. Now scroll down and click here, generate password. Now again, it will generate a password by itself. We don't want this kind of password, you know. We want our own password. So you can choose any password of your choice. Okay, it says it's a weak password. So click over here, confirm use of weak password, and click on update profile. So this is the first thing you are gonna do. Make sure you change the password of your website. Make sure you do that. It says your site is currently displaying a coming soon page. Once you are ready to launch your site, click here. So let's click here. Okay, so our website is now launched. It says WordPress 4.7.2 is available for you. Some newer version will be available if you're watching this video in the future. But whatever latest update is available, make sure you update that. Click on update now. If you're using the latest version, you won't see this option, so don't worry. Okay, so WordPress is successfully installed on our website. Let's see how our website looks like. Just however, here you'll see something called visit site. Open this link in a new tab. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is how our website looks like right now. But this is not the website we want. We want something amazing, something awesome, something like this. We want to create this website into this. So let's do that. For that, we need something called theme, because this is a theme installed, a design installed on the WordPress on our website. So for that, we need a theme. I have given a link in the video description below. You can check out that link. When you click on that link, you will be directly redirected to the theme page, or else you can do one thing. Type in blogdude.com/nitro, because our theme name is Nitro. The theme which we are using in this particular tutorial, it's Nitro. So once you type in that, you will be redirected to this particular page. So this is the theme we'll be using. It's an amazing theme. It's a beautiful theme. As you can see, with this theme, we made this beautiful website. It's an amazing thing. And there are so many different features, so many awesome features available in this theme. And the great thing which I like about this theme is that you get so many top selling plugins free with this particular theme. For example, we're getting Slider Revolution, Meta Boxes, Visual Composer, Ninja Pop-up, Size Guide, Advanced Product Filter, and we'll be using all this thing in creating our website. So if you go out to buy these plugins, it will cost you around $155 plus the cost of the theme. But when you buy this theme, it's only for $60 and you get all those themes, all those plugins worth $155 free of cost with this theme. So go ahead and buy this theme. Click on buy now. Choose your payment method, Visa or MasterCard if you're choosing. You can also pay with PayPal. I have already purchased and bought this theme, so I won't be, you know, purchasing it again. Okay guys, so once you purchase the theme, you will get this file. We now have to install this file on our website. So again, come back to the dashboard of our website. This is the dashboard of our website. And hover appearances and select theme. Now because we have the file and want to upload the theme, here you'll see an option, a button called upload. Just click on that button. And again, here you'll see something called upload theme. Click on upload theme. Now click on choose file. And choose that file. I have saved that file on my desktop. So here is the file. Choose this file. Make sure this file is selected and click on open. Now click on install now. If you're using Google Chrome, you'll see the progress over here, left bottom. So while our theme is getting installed, you can do one thing. You can subscribe to my channel because you'll get a lot to learn from my channel. This is my channel. You can click on the subscribe button over here. Okay, so our theme is getting installed. Okay, it says installing the theme. The theme is installed successfully. Now what we have to do is activate the theme on the website. So click on activate. Once you click on activate, first thing we have to do is product registration. Here, as you can see, you have to put in your email address and purchase code, which you will get with this theme. So first thing you have to do is this, because until and unless you do this, you won't be able to, you know, take advantage of all these premium plugins. So go ahead and put in your email address and purchase code. Okay guys, so once you put in the email address and your purchase code, you'll get this message: thank you for choosing Nitro. Now what we have to do is install all the plugins which we need. So for that, just click on over here, begin installing plugins. Or if you don't get this option, then come down and here you'll see plugins. So from here, click this one, install all recommended plugins. So you can either install it from here or install it from here. It's all up to you. So click on install and select this thing. When you tick mark over here, as you can see, all the plugin is selected. Fine. Now from bulk action, select install and click on apply. So all our plugins is getting installed. Okay, all installation have been completed. Now click here, return to required plugin installer. Now again, tick mark over here, so everything will get selected. And now we have to activate all the plugins. So select activate and click on apply. Okay guys, so all our plugins have been successfully installed and activated. Now again, let's come back to the website and refresh the website. First, let's see, this is how the website looked before installing the theme on the website. Now let's refresh and see how it looks like after installing the theme on the website. Okay guys, so as you can see, it looks much better than before, but still it doesn't look like this. You know, we don't have all this stuff over here. So let's start creating all this thing. The first thing which we'll be creating is this slider over here. So let's get started with that. So come back to your dashboard, scroll down, and here you'll see something called slider revolution. Click on slider revolution. Now we have to create a new slider. So what we do is just click on over here, new slider. Now we have to give some name to the slider. You can give any name. For example, I'm giving slider rev 1. Okay, same thing over here. Fine. Now we have to choose the size or the resolution of the slider. So for this example, for this website, we are choosing 847 × 458. So over here, put in 847 pixels, and over here, put in 458 pixels. Fine. Now at top, you'll see some options over here, as you can see. So select navigation and click on enable arrows. Now from here, select bullets and again enable bullets. So basically we want to enable arrow and bullets from navigation setting. So what will that do? As you can see, these are the bullets and these are the arrows. So we are enabling this two from here. So once you do that, just click on save over here, save settings. Okay, now the first thing what we have to do is go to general settings and make sure slide delay is 4000 milliseconds, which is 4 seconds. And slide animation, it is selected fade. We don't want fade. We want parallax to bottom, this one. And we also want curtain transaction, curtain from right. So select these two and from here, cancel this fade. So we have to do two settings over here. We have to change the delay time and slide animation. So once you do that, come down and now we have to start working with this slider. So as you can see over here in our slider, we have a background. So let's first select the background. So for that, what we do is come up over here and main background, as you can see, this is the option. Select this one, main background image, and select media library. You can select some image from the library, but we don't have anything right now. So we can also upload the file. So select files and upload the background if you want, any background you want. I have already selected my background. This is the background I'll be using. So select this and click on open. Now from here, click insert. So as you can see, we have the image in the background now. Now let's minimize the size so that we can see it properly. Fine. This looks better. Now what we have to do is we have to put in this headline, sub headline and call to action button on the slider. So let's first put in this experience. For that, we have to add a text. So what we do is over here, you'll see an option called add layer. So hover that and select text or HTML. And here type in anything you want. For example, in the example, we have experience. So we'll type in experience. Fine. And now, as you can see here, we'll see the experience, but it looks so small. And here we have the bigger size, the color is different, the font is different. So now let's change that. So when you select this thing, you'll get so many options over here. So first option is style template. We have to select the font. So in this example, I am selecting the Lato font. Select Lato from here. Now we have to change the font size and font weight. So first let's change the font size. We want a bigger font. So let's put in 40 pixels for this. And for line height, we want 70 pixels. And font weight, we want 900 pixels. Just select 900 from here. But still we are not seeing the text over here because the color is different. So let's select the black color from here. From here, as you can see, just drag it till here. Drag it till the bottom. Fine. Now we get the perfect black. So we have done with that. Now we have to add the sub headline. It says of professional high-end electronic shop. So let's again hover add layer and select text or HTML and type in the font of professional high-end electronic shop. Fine. Now again we want different font, so select Lato from Google Fonts from here. And now we have to change the size of the font. So from here select 14 pixels and line height will be 36 pixels and font weight will be 400. It's fine. Now we have to change the color. As you can see, we cannot see the color. We won't keep it black, but something like gray color. So I have a code for that. You can select the color from here, as you can see, or you can put in the code, font code. So the code is, use the code I'm using, 2A2929. So this is the color I'll be using, as you can see over here. Once you're done that, just click on over here. Fine. Now we have this thing over here. Now what we have to do is add this button, call to action button. So again, hover add layer and select button. So as you can see, we have many different kind of button. So I'm selecting this one. So just click this one and drag it wherever you want to keep it. I want it over here. Fine. Now what we have to do is change the text, obviously, again. So first select Lato. Okay. Font size will be 14 pixels. Line height will be 42 pixels and font weight will be around 700 pixels. Fine. This looks good. Now we can also redirect this button to some page if you want. So from here we have to select the action button and we have to click on this plus button, and on click, as you can see, it is disabled. From here you can select anything you want, what you want to do with when someone clicks on this button. Suppose you want to link this to some different page, so select simple link and you can put in that URL over here, the link of the, for example, I want to link that button to my website blogdude.com. So I put in my URL over here, same window. Do you want to open the URL in the same window or new window? Select that. Fine. So you can link it to anything you want. You can link it to any product, to any page of your choice. So this is done. Now we have to do something with the animation. So as you can see, when the slide changes, we see some animation, the heading comes first and so on. So now we have to do this animation. For that, we have to change the timing. For example, when you saw the heading came first, the subheading came second. So for that, hover here, click on this pencil. Now when you see here, you'll get an option called edit. When we hover over this thing, the red mark, we get an option called edit. Just select that option. Now we have to change the timings. When should the heading start? The first heading, which is experience. When should this start? At what time? So I am selecting 900 milliseconds. Okay. And how long should it the animation go? How long the animation should exist for? So I am selecting 1000 milliseconds, which is 1 second. Fine. Now when we hover over here, we again get an option called edit. Select this option. Now here also we can change the timing. I'm putting 4000, that is 4 seconds, since our slider is for 4 seconds, and duration I'm putting 330. I'm sorry, just 330, and again tick mark this. Now come over here and edit this also. We also want to edit the timing over here. Put in 1500, that is 1.5 seconds, and over here put in 1000, that is 1 seconds. Again edit the timing, 4000, this is right, and over here put in 710. Fine. Now select this one, click on edit. this should come the last, so delete all the number over here, because we want our call to action button to come at last. We want it at to come at 2.3 seconds to put in 2003 milliseconds, and in duration put in 350 milliseconds. Now come over here, how are this, click on edit. This is 4000, good, and this should be 400 milliseconds. Now click on this, fine. So we have selected the timing for the animation. Now we have to select the animation, obviously. So first click on experience over here. So as you can see, now experience is selected. So click on over here, animation. So as you can see, there are many options over here. What we have to select for first one is smooth slide from bottom. So let's this one, smooth slide from bottom, fine. And from here, select short to top. Short to top, here it is. You can obviously choose anything you want, but I have used this in my demo website, so I'm using the same settings over here. And from here, choose power 4 is out. You'll get this option over here, power 4 is out. And here we will select no change, fine. So as you can see over here, the animation is showing. Now select the second one, the sub headline, and we are selecting the same settings. First will be smooth slide from bottom, and here it will be short to top. Okay, here it is, short to top, power 4 is out, and no change. Now select the call to action button, and again select the animation. You can select different animation obviously for the different inputs, but I am selecting this one, smooth slide from bottom. From here I am selecting short to top, power 4 is out, and no change. Okay, fine. So we have successfully made our first slider. As you can see, we have two sliders. So similarly, you can make the second slider also. What I'm doing is just clicking on save slide so that we don't miss anything which we have done. Okay, so similarly, you can create another slide from here. Just click on add new slide, and we can create similarly as many different slides as you want. So what I'll do is just duplicate this slide so that I don't have to waste your time showing the same thing again. So I have duplicated this slide. We have two slides right now. Now click on save slide. We are saving this slide. So we have successfully created this slide. Now what we have to do is create a home page and put in this slider on the home page. So let's come back to our dashboard and do that. When we come back to our dashboard, we see something called pages over here. How are pages, and select add new. Now here put the title of the page, so put in home page or anything you want. Now click on publish. Now let's refresh the website and see if we are seeing new page or not. Let's refresh our website. We see no changes over here because we have not made this page our home page. We have just created a page named home page, but we haven't made this page our home page. So come back to your dashboard and click on customize. Now from here, select system, a static page. First it is selected your latest post. Now select a static page, and from front page select home page, because we have just created a page called home page. So now we have made that page as our official home page. We can also select a post page, but we haven't created a post page yet. We'll be creating in the future, don't worry about that. Fine, once you do that, just click on save and publish. Okay, now cancel this thing. Fine, so we have made that page as our home page. Now let's add the slider which we have created on the home page. So for that, come back to your dashboard, click on backend editor here, visual editor. So we are using the visual editor. Click on backend editor, and from here click on add element, and on the search bar type in slider revolution. As you can see, here it is, slider revolution 5. Select that one and select this slide. As you remember, we have created this slide. So select this one and click add selected slider. So we have successfully added the slider on our home page, but as you can see, we have a slider plus categories section over here. So what we have to do is divide this thing into two sections, a slider section and a category section. When we hover here, we see different options. We want 1x3 and 2x3, but we are not getting that option. So what you can do is click on custom. Okay, fine. And we can choose any custom layout for your row. So we'll select 1x3. Now click on update. See, we are getting 1x3. Now we see 1x3 plus 2x3. Now click on update again. Fine, now we have this thing. We have one row over here and one over here. We have our slider revolution over here at present. That is in this row. We don't want in this column. We want it in the bigger column. So what you have to do is just select this one and drag it to the bigger column. Fine. So we have put our thing, our slider on the bigger column. Now we have to add this thing. First, let's publish and update the page and see how it looks like. Let's click on update. Okay, so this is our website. Now let's refresh the page and see whether we are getting the slider or not. Click on refresh. Okay guys, so as you can see, now we are getting the slider successfully. It is looking very beautiful, but we are also seeing this thing over here, and in the demo website we don't have anything like that, so we have to remove this thing. So let's remove this. Again, come back to the page editor, and at the bottom you'll see something called page option. So deselect this one, use global settings. Fine. Now come to page title, and also deselect this one, show page title. So we don't want to show the page title. So make sure you deselect the global setting and also deselect the page title. Once you do that, again click on update. Now again, let's refresh the page and see whether the changes have taken place or not. Okay guys, so as you can see, now we can see the changes. There is no such thing over here. Everything looks clean. Now let's add this section, product categories section. Before adding this section, we have to create different product categories. So let's do that. Come back to your dashboard, and at the left side, you'll see something called products, hover over products, and select categories. Now we have to add different categories, product categories. Okay, now let's see what categories we have. We have camera, activity trackers, car accessories. So let's add that. First, it's camera. Put in camera. In slug, you can keep it blank. Fine. It's asking for display type. Don't do anything. But for thumbnail, as you can see, we have a small thumbnail for camera. So select this one. We have to upload a thumbnail. We don't have anything. So what we'll do, upload some files. I'm uploading all the images at once. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is the icon for camera. So I'll select this one and click on use image. Fine. Now click on add new product category. Okay, so as you can see, the product category is successfully added, camera, and we are getting the thumbnail also. Then we have activity trackers. Now let's add this. We have activity trackers. Again, let's add the thumbnail for activity trackers. Here it is. Use image, add new product category. We have car accessories. Fine. Now let's add the thumbnail for car accessories. Okay, again add new product category. Then we have game control. Now let's put in the name game control, thumbnail, then we have headphone, mouse, phone and tablets. Fine, so let's add headphone. Select the thumbnail for headphone. Click on add new product category. Then we have mouse, thumbnail for mouse, this one, news image, add new product category, phone and tablets. So put in phone in the name section. I'm sorry, phone. Okay, let's delete this because we have by mistakenly added this. So click on here, click OK. Now let's put in phone. I'm sorry again. Thumbnail, click on add new product category. Then you have tablets. Thumbnail. Fine. So okay guys, so we have successfully added all the product categories. Now what we have to do is add these things over here. So let's do that. For that, again come back to your pages, click on pages, because we have to add this on the pages on our home page. Fine, now select the home page from here. Okay, here we want to add the categories, so click on this plus sign over here, and in the search element type in product categories. Okay, product categories. And in the title, put in shop by category or anything you want. I have put in shop by category, so I'm using the same. And you use always expand setting. You can exclude some category. For example, when you type in camera, we can exclude this category, fine, but we don't want to do that. Just put in enable thumbnail because we want to show the thumbnails over here. So put in enable thumbnail and leave this thing blank and click on save changes. Now click on update. Okay, so once we have updated the page, again let's come back to our website and refresh the website and see the changes. Okay guys, so as you can see, we are seeing the changes and it is really looking beautiful. So we are really going good. We have created the slider, we have created the categories. Now what we have to do is create this different categories, these different banners. We have three different banners, so let's do that. Again, come back to your page. Now click on over here, the add element, and we have to add banners, we have to create banners. So click on add element and type in banners. So as you can see, we are getting an option called banner. Select that one, and in the effect, select effect 2. Now select an image. I'll be uploading the image for three different banners. So first one, select image. Fine. The alignment will be left, container inside banner text, because inside the banner we want some text. As you can see, we have text watches up to 30% off. Fine. Now the heading text will be watches. And description will be 30% off. Fine. Now we have to select the text color. I'm selecting 28 28 28. Put in this thing to use the same color if you want. Fine. Now click on save changes. So we have selected, we have successfully created the banner. But as you can see, in our demo website, we have three banners over here. So what we have to do is hover over here and we have to create three different columns. So select three columns. So as you can see, this is the one, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3. Just click on this one, and as you can see, while we are getting two new columns over here. So similarly, you can repeat the same steps and create two different banners for this thing. I'm just copying this two times and dragging and dropping this on these two different columns. Fine. Now let's update the page and see how it looks like now. Now let's refresh the page and see the changes. Okay guys, so now as you can see, we are seeing the banners, but there are some problem. The problem is we are not getting that kind of style. So for that, I'll tell you what to do. Come back to your page. And here at the top, you'll see something called setting a gear icon. Here is the gear icon. This is to put in custom CSS code. Just click on this gear icon, and at the bottom of this video description you'll see a link to a page on my website. Just click on that link. Okay guys, so once you click on that link, you will be redirected to this particular page, and here you'll find something called homepage CSS code. So below that you'll see some CSS code. Just copy those code, copy it, all the code, fine, till here, fine. Click on Ctrl plus C. Now again come back to your page. Where is it? Here it is, and paste it over here. Now click on Save Changes. Now again click on Update. Now again come back to your website, and before refreshing the website, see how it looks like, and after refreshing the website everything should be fine. Now let's refresh the website. Okay, so as you can see now it looks really great. It is looking beautiful. So this is what we wanted. Now it looks good. The animation is also fine. So this is how you create banners, different banners. Now let's add these products. So before adding the products, we obviously have to create some products. So let's do that. Okay guys, for that again come back to your dashboard, and here you'll see something called products. Let's find, here it is. Now hover products and select add product, because now we are going to add different products. This is the most important part obviously, because this is what this is the main thing in the website. We have to add some products, the descriptions and so on. Here we have to type in the name of the product. So type in any name of the product, any name you want. Fine, we have type in the Apple iPhone 6 16GB gold. Now from here you have to select the category. We have created different categories for product, and this comes under phone obviously, so select phone. And this is how your product will look like once we create. Really beautiful. Here the name of the product will show, which we have just put in, as you can see. Then we have a short description over here. Let's copy this and paste it over here. Okay, fine. So a short description will come over here. Product short description. Fine. So paste it over here. We also have a long description which will be there at the bottom. Fine. Here is the long description. Just copy this thing. Come and paste it over here. So this is the long description. Now again scroll down and make sure simple is selected from here, and you can put in the regular price of the product, for example anything obviously according to you. I am putting £550. We will change the currency later on. Fine. Inventory, you can put in the SKU, which is the stock keeping unit. It's all up to you, whatever you want to put. I am putting NS12. Fine. Stock status, in stock or out of stock, obviously we want to keep it in stock. Shipping, you can put in the weight, the length, width, height of the product you want. Link product attributes, we'll see this later on, attributes and advanced option, but for now this is what we have to do. We have to put in the regular price of the product. Fine, you can put in some tags. For example, you can put in iPhone for this. iPhone could be a tag for this, and click on add. Now we have to select the image of the product. So click on select product image. Upload the image. Select any image of your choice. For example, I'm selecting this one. Just click on open. Now click on set product image. So this image will show up over here. Fine, this image will show up over here, and we also have two different images over here. So let's upload those. Here you have the option called product gallery. Just click on add product gallery images. Upload the file. Fine. Let's see, suppose we want to add these three as our product gallery image. Select these three images, click on open. Fine. Now click on add to gallery. So we have successfully uploaded the product gallery images. Now let's update and publish the product and see how our first product looks like. Click on publish. Now let's open this product in a new tab. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is how our product looks like right now. This was an example of simple product. So what happens, sometimes we give some discount on the product. So let's see how we do the discounting thing. So again, come back to the product. Here in the general option, we did 550 for regular. Suppose you wanna give some discount on this product. So what you can do is in sale price, you can put in different amount, obviously lesser than the regular price. So suppose the regular price is 550 pounds. Now we are, you know, entering 500 pounds for this product. Fine. And we can also schedule this, as I showed you the counter, the countdown of the product for the sale. Suppose we are giving this sale for 24 hours. So if you purchase within 24 hours, you'll get a 50 pound discount. And we can select show counter timer. So select this thing and click on update. So again, let's come back to the product and see the changes. So refresh the product. So as you can see, the old price is now striked off and we are getting the new price, that is 500 pounds. And we also have a counter which is for 21 hours. So if we buy this product within 21 hours, we'll get a 50 pound discount. So basically this is how you enter a sales product. Now let me show you how to enter or how to insert a variable product. Variable product is a different kind of product. Suppose you're selling iPhone and you have three different versions, 16 GB, 32 GB, 64 GB. So that is a variable product. Or if you have different colors, for example, gold, gray, white. So these are different variables. So let's see how to do that. Come back to the product page, scroll down, and instead of simple product, now select variable product. Fine. Now come to attributes. We have custom product attribute. Now click on add. Now we have to name the attribute. For example, we want to add different colors. So put in color over here and make sure used for variation is tick mark. Now let's see two different examples. For example, gold and gray, maybe. Fine. Now click on save attributes. Now select variations and click over here and select create variation from all attributes and click on go. Now click on OK. OK. So we have two different variations for this product, gold and gray. So select first one and you can put any price, for example 550, and we are selling this. If you want to put some sale price, you can put the sale price for this one. And suppose for gray, we are selling it only for $500 or 500 pounds. So for gold, it is 550 and for gray, it is 500. Fine. Now let's update and see the changes in the product. Now again, let's refresh and see the changes. Now as you can see, it shows from 500 to 550 different variation. Now here we have the option called color. So if we choose gray, as you can see, now we're getting 550 price, and when we choose different color, we get different price. Okay, so this is what our variation product is. Now what we have to do is add different products on our homepage, as I showed you. So just like this, we have to add different product on our homepage. So I have shown you how to create a product, a simple product, variable product, a discounted product. So now I'll pause this video for some time and I'll create this different product so that we can put these products on our homepage. I have shown you how to create the product. So you can create as many products as you want. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have created all the products. So next step, what we have to do is add these products on our homepage. So let's do that. First, we have to add this headline. So let's come back to the homepage. Come here, click on this plus sign and type in custom heading. Select this one. In the text, type in new arrival or whatever you want. In the element tag, type in H4. Text alignment will be left, fine. Font size will be 20 pixels. Line height 20 pixels. And tick mark this, use theme default font family. And here, type in FWB. And click on save changes. Fine, so we have done this. I'm sorry. Now we have to add these products. So what we do is click on this plus sign and type in products over here. So instead of all products, we'll select category and we want to show only phone category, and we want per page 5 products and 5 columns. Okay, you can choose any style. I'm choosing style 2. Click on save changes. So basically, when we do that, we are done with all this thing, the bestseller and this one. Now let's add the advert, the advertisement over here. Let's do that. So click on this plus sign and type in single image. Select the image you want to add. I'm selecting this one first. Instead of image size thumbnail, we want full size image. Alignment should be center. Okay. We have many different kind of, you know, animations available. We can select anyone. I'm selecting this one. Now click on save changes. But as you can see in the website, we have 2 adverts. So what again we have to do is hover here and select 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 to divide this into 2 columns. Now what I do is copy this thing and drag it over here. Fine. So basically by doing that, we have done this portion. Now we have to add the tabs over here. So we want to type in new arrivals first. So again, click on this plus sign and search for custom heading. Type in new arrival over here. Element tag will be H4. Fine, font size will be 20. Line height 20 pixels. Use font default. And here it will be FWB. Now click on save changes. Now we have to add the tab. As you can see, when we click on different category, different product shows up. So for that, we have to add an element called tag. So click on this plus sign, search for tabs, select this one. And as you can see, first tab is selected. So click on this edit button. And instead of tab 1, type in phone. Click on save changes. Now we have to add some product in this tab. For example, when we click on phone, we see phones. So that is what we have to do, add some product in the phone tab. So click on this plus sign and search for products. Select this one. Instead of all products, select category and select phone. Per page, 5 products. And obviously 5 columns. You can select any style of your choice. Click on save. Now select the second tab and do the same. First change the title of the tab. Instead of second tab, we have to type in something like camera. Save changes. Now again click on this plus sign to add some products. in the tab, select this product, and instead of all products category, and this time we have to select camera, and obviously per page it will be 5 and 5 columns, any style of your choice, any style you can choose. Now click on save changes. So by doing that, we have completed this step. Now what we have to do is add this brand icons, brand logos. So again, come back to your home page, click on this plus sign and type in Nitro Carousel. Select Nitro Carousel. We want 6 logos. Okay, so type in 6 and click on save changes. Now we have to add some image in this one, so click on this plus sign and select this single image. Fine, click on here to select the image. Select any image of your choice. I'm selecting this one. Click on set image. Instead of thumbnail, we want full size image. So type in full. Alignment should be center. Rest everything is fine. So click on save changes. We want 6 images. So instead of doing and repeating the same step, I am duplicating this 6 times. Fine. But when you see over here, we have 2 thin lines or thin borders at top and bottom of this image. So let's do that. For that, click over here, edit this row, select the design options, and for border select 1 pixel for top and 1 pixel for bottom, and margin, as you can see, this is the margin portion. Select 0 pixel for left and 0 pixel for right margin, and 60 pixels for bottom margin. And because we have border, we have to select some color for the border. So this is the color we are selecting. Any color, obviously, you can choose. Now border style will be solid. Fine. Now we can save changes. And also, when we see in the example, we have some gap between the line, the border and the image. So let's do that. Click on over here, this edit this column. Again, design options, and select 15 per pixels padding top and bottom. Click on save changes. Fine. Now click on update and let's see the changes which have taken place on the website. Now let's come back to our website and refresh the page. Let's scroll down. As you can see, all the changes have taken place. Now we can see this thing. The products are showing up. We are seeing the ad. The tab is working fine, and we also have this brand images. Now the next step is to create blogs, different blogs. So let's do that. Let's create a blog page and create different blogs. So for that, come back to your dashboard and over here click on add new, because now we have to add a new page, a blog page. Enter the title of the page, just type in blog and click on publish. Fine. Now again, come back to your website, click on customize. Now because we want to make this page as our official blog page, now from here select system, a static page, and post page, select this one and select the blog page. Fine. Now click on save and publish. Then again go back to the link on my website. Fine, scroll down. Okay, you'll find something called custom code for pages. As you can see over here, custom code for pages. To copy this code, all the code, fine, just copy it, come back over here, click on over here set code and paste all the code over here. Fine. Now click on save. So once you do that, click on save and publish. Now click this button to go back, and you'll see a option called blog. Select that one, select blog list, and from layout select the fourth layout. and from column select this second column. Item style will be the item style number one, that is this one. Okay, rest everything looks fine. We don't want any sidebar, so we are not selecting any sidebar over here. Fine. So once you do that, again click on save and publish. Now cancel this. We have one post, which is the default post, which is always there by default. So now we have to create some new posts, some new blocks. So let's do that. Again, come back to your dashboard, hover a post and click on add new. Okay, fine. So we can enter any title for the blog or the post. Let's see, for example, in our demo website, we have iMac and MacBook Pro Retina. So copy this title, paste it over here. And this thing should look you something familiar with Word, Microsoft Word. So it is very easy to, you know, write any blog or create new blogs, new post. Fine. So we can type something, for example, Nayar Sheikh. You can increase the size of the text by from selecting from here. You can, for example, as you can see, when I select heading 1, heading 2, the size changes. I can also change the color of the text, for example, like this. And there are so many different things which can be done. I can, you know, bullet point, make this thing a bullet point. I can bold, and it's really easy. It is just like using Microsoft Word. We can add some media also in the email, in this blog. For example, let's see, we want to add this image. So click on insert into post. And as you can see, we are seeing the post. And suppose we want to align this left, we can also do that. So you can do a lot of things in blog. Okay, so let's copy and paste this thing from here, because we don't want to waste our time doing this. Fine. As you can see, many things have been used over here. The bulleted points, we have inserted an image over here. We are using different headings. Fine. Okay, so once you do that, click on publish. But before that, you see something called categories. We have created categories, but that was different. That was for products, and for blogs we have different categories. So from here also you can create a category. Just click on add new category. Suppose this post, this blog belongs to technology, so you can call it technology. So we have new category called technology. Click on add new category. So this is selected. Okay, fine. We can also add a featured image. What is a featured image? Let me show you what is a featured image. For example, when we see the blog page over here, these are the featured image. So let's upload one, because that is really important. It really beautifies the post. Let's upload one image for featured image. Let's select this one. Okay, fine. Click on set featured image. As you can see, now it is showing. Now let's publish this post. And again, come back to our blog page and refresh, and let's see how it looks like now. Okay, so as you can see, now we can see our page, our blog post over here. So let me create some extra blogs, some dummy blogs, just to show you how it looks like. Similarly, I have shown you how to create one blog. You can create as many blogs as you want, but this is how you do it. Okay, fine. Now let me create some blogs, because I have to add those blog on our homepage. As you can see, on our homepage also we have latest blogs, so we are seeing three latest blogs. So let me create some dummy blogs. So let me pause this video and create some dummy blogs so that I can show you how it looks like. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have created some dummy blogs, some dummy post. So let me show you how to put this thing on the home page. As you can see, this is how it looks like. Last three blocks will show on the home page. So let's do that. Again, come back to the dashboard, select pages, and select home page. Now again scroll down and click on this plus button and search for custom heading. Type in your text over here. Element tag should be H4. Font size is 20. Line height is 20 pixels. Fine. Default font. Extra class name will be FWB. Click on save changes. And as you can see in the demo website, we have two different columns, one for blogs and one for gallery. So let's create two different columns. How over here, click on half by half. Now as you can see, we have two different columns over here. Now let's add blogs in our first column. So click on this plus sign. Search for blogs. So you'll find this blog post. Select this one. So you can order by anything, for example, recent post, last modified, you know, special post. I'm selecting recent post. You can sort it according to ascending or descending order. You can exclude some post over here. Now in the layer, make sure minimal is selected and total post, we want to show only 3. So select 3 over here and make sure number of posts displayed is 3. And make this gutter 0. Then we have different options like font size and so on. So font size will be 14 pixels. Fine, and this is fine. Rest everything looks fine, so just click on save changes. Now what we have to do is click this, create this gallery. So let's do this. Again click on this plus sign. Search for custom heading. Type in our custom heading over here. Element tag will be H4. Fine. 20 pixel for line height. Default font family we want. And FWB. Just type in that. Click on save changes. And now we have to add the gallery. So click on the plus button and search for image gallery. This one, select this one. And gallery type, make sure image grid is selected. Fine. Now we have to select different images. So click on this. Now upload image. Okay, so we have selected these 6 images. So click on add images. And instead of thumbnail, obviously it will be full size image. Now click on save changes. And over here, click on edit this row. In the extra class name, type in latest blog. Latest dash blog. Fine, click on save changes. Now let's update this page and see the changes. Okay, fine, as you can see there are changes, but not the changes what we want. Fine, this is fine, this looks good. We have to change this type, the style is different. So let's again come back, scroll down, edit the blog post. Okay, here it is. Number of columns should be 1, I'm sorry. And click on save changes. Now again click on update. Okay, this looks fine. So we have done this also. Now we have to add the icons, these different icons. So again come back to the home page, scroll down, click on this plus button and search for icon box. This is the one we want. Select this one. Okay, in style select icon and type in the content. For example, when we see in the demo website, the content is AM or PM delivery, just $9.99. So just copy this, paste it over here. Now we have to select the text color. So I am selecting 898989, a bit darkish color. Fine. Now come to icon setting. Now instead of font awesome, select line cons. This is the one I'm talking about. And now let's select the icon. As you can see in the demo website, we have a clock. So come here in the search bar, type in clock, and this is the one we want. Select this one. Now what we have to do is select the icon color. So instead of this color, you can select any color you want. It's all up to you. You can also select the icon hover color. You can have different color for icon hover color. Okay. Now scroll down and mark this yes, enable box wrap icon. Fine. And the position should be left. This should be 64x64. And this is fine, circle. And background color, let's select some color. You can select different color for the background. As you can see over here, we have different color for the background. So let's type in some color. For example, let's select this color. Fine. Then you can select hover color. Any different color of your choice, any color if you want. Fine. Now let's come back to the heading section. Type in the heading you want. For example, over here we have suit your time. So let's copy this, type in over here. And in font family, we want the same. In text transform, make it uppercase. Spacing should be 2 pixels. And font size we want 14, and margin bottom should be only 5. Okay, fine. Make sure you have all these changes. Okay, so in the background setting, left and right padding should be 20 pixels. Fine, click on save changes. Okay, so in the demo website, as you can see, we have 3 different icons with 3 different messages. You'll create the same icon the similar way as I have shown you. The only difference is just the icons are changed. So you can do that because I have taught you how to do this. Now let's create 3 different columns. Not 4, 3 different columns. Fine. So instead of creating the same thing again, let me duplicate this and put this in different boxes. Fine. Now if you see this, we have a very thin border over here at top and bottom. So let's do those changes. Click on this design option. Top and bottom border will be 1 pixel. The margin for left, right and bottom will be 0. Border color, we have to select some, you know, soft color for border. Fine. It should be solid. Okay, once you do this, click on save changes. Now with this, we have added 2 different borders, top and bottom border. But here also, as you can see, we have 2 borders, left and right border for this icon. So let's select this one, design option, 1 pixel border for left and right, border color or anything of your choice. Style should be solid, obviously. Now click on save changes. Now let's click on update and see the changes that have taken place. Again, refresh the page. Okay, as you can see guys, the changes have taken place, but we have some problem with the bottom margin. So again, come back over here. Okay, select the icon. and in background setting type in 5 pixel for bottom margin and click on save changes. Similarly for all this thing, 5 pixel for bottom margin, click on save changes. You also now let's update and hopefully everything should be fine now. Okay, it is looking much better. I think we need more gap, so instead of 5 you can increase that to 25 or 30. That would look better. Now let's add this newsletter section. So again, come back to the page, click on plus button. Search for custom heading. And type in the text. Here the text is subscribe to our newsletter. So just copy over here, paste it over here. And this time it would be H3 because as you can see the font is bigger as compared to earlier one. Fine. And here the font size will also be bigger, so type in 24 and 30 pixel for height, line height. Fine, tick mark this, use default font family. And now in the extra class CSS name, type in ls-2 space fwb. Okay, fine. Now in the design option, top and bottom margin will be 0. Sorry, top margin will be 0, bottom margin will be 5. Okay, now click on save changes. Now click over here at this row. In the design option, top and bottom padding should be 60 pixels. So type in 60 both over here and now click on save changes. Okay, so again as you can see we have two different columns over here. One is for text and another one is for subscribe button. So what we do is divide this into two different columns. Fine. Now again we have to add this text. So let's copy this text. Click on this plus button. Now search for text block. Yeah. And instead of this, paste in our own text. And in the design option, margin bottom should be 0. Fine. Now click on save changes. Now we have to add this over here. Fine. So click on this plus button. Type in subscribe. So you'll get subscription form, select this one. Now we have to link it to our MailChimp form. So for that, go to MailChimp.com and sign up for a free account. I already have an account, so I won't sign up. I'm logging in. Okay guys, so once you sign up or log in for MailChimp, go to list, click over here, create a new list, you can name it anything. Okay, your email address, you can put in your email address, your name. Fine, it's really easy. Some description, your organization name, your address and all this thing, and click on save. Fine, so you have successfully created a list. Now the next thing is to create a sign up form. So click on sign up forms. Now select the embedded forms. Okay, fine. Now here you have some code, so scroll down, you'll see something called action form, form action, and after that you have some code. Okay, so copy this much. We need this much of code. Fine, the form action code. copy this and paste it over here. This will link your MailChimp account with the newsletter form. Okay, you can enter any placeholder you want. And for the form width, we want 400 pixels into 40 pixels height. Okay. You can select any background color. Okay, suppose we want green, red, whatever you want. Then we have border width. So what you have to put is 0 space 0 space 1 pixel space 0. So put this thing over there and click on save changes. Now click on update. And again, come back to the website and let's see the changes. So refresh the page. Right, so as you can see, now we have the newsletter thing over here. Okay, we have the sub headline over here and our form is over here. But this is coming in two different lines. We don't want that. And here also we cannot see the text, what is written. So again, come back over here. First, let's change this. So click on edit on the text block. And what we have to do is just cut this thing and just delete everything from here, from the text section. Make sure you're in the text section. Here is the text section. This was the visual. This is the text section, and paste that text over here and click on save changes. And in the subscription form, edit this. Okay, background color was black, so our text color should be white or some different color so that we can read what was written. Now click on save changes. Again, click on update. Okay guys, so now what we have to do is click on over here and scroll down, and in the extra class CSS name, type in section-subscribe. Okay, now click on save changes, update this page. Okay guys, with this we have created the home page. Now let's create the contact us page. To create the contact us page, first we will have to create a contact form like this. So again, come back to your dashboard. At the left side you'll see something called contact. So hover that and select add new. And again, go back to that link and scroll down, and you'll see something called copy this code, contact form. Just copy this code and name this form anything, for example form 12, anything you want. And just select everything, delete it, and copy this code from here and paste it over here. Fine. Now click on save. Now again, hover over pages and click on add new. Now we have to create a contact us page. So in the title, type in contact us. Fine, and click on publish. Okay, fine guys, so now we have to add this map over here and also the contact form. So first go to backend editor, click over here, add an element, Google Maps, type in Google Maps, select this one. Okay, you have to have an API to show this map on your website. If you don't have an API, the map will not show on your website. So for that, you have to go to a link. I have given that link in the video description below. That is console.developers.google.com. Okay, once you go there, at the left side, as you can see, there are three options. You have to select the credentials. Fine. And click on create credentials and select API key. You'll get an API key. Just copy that come back over here and paste it over here. Okay, click on close. Many a times it happens that even after doing this, the map doesn't show up on your website. So what you can do is click on library, and here is the Google Map API section. So you can select each and everything one by one. For example, let's select Google Map Geocoding API. And here for me it is showing disable, but for you it will show enable. So click on enable. So for every Google Map API you have to enable all this thing. After that it will surely show, don't worry about that. Now you have to put in your address or the latitude longitude code so that the map will show up. For that there is another website, latlong.net, so you can visit that website. You can write the or type the name of the place over here and it will give you the latitude and longitude code. For example, I'm typing in Mumbai and click on find. Okay, so you get the latitude and longitude code. Just copy those code and paste in the respective columns. Fine. In the height, put in 229 pixels. Width will be 100%. Okay, fine. Everything looks fine over here. From roadmap, you can select anything like terrain or hybrid. Okay, so I'm selecting terrain. Now click on save changes. So we have the Google map over here. Now we can divide this column into two. And here we can add the contact form. So search for contact form 7 and select this one. We have created this form 12 as you remember. Click on save changes. And again over here you see the gear icon. Just click on that and go to that link which I have given you. You'll find this contact us page CSS code. Just copy this code and paste it over here. Now click on save changes and click on update. Okay, so as you can see the contact us page is showing now, but as you can see this is not looking good. You know, the color is different. Here it is pure white and it is gray on the top. So we want to, you know, make this color also, the breadcrumb color also white. So let's do that. So for that, click on customize. Select color, page title, and deselect this one, use general color. Now click on here. And here you'll see some codes. So what you have to do is after asterisk type 6 times F, fine, and click on choose. Okay, now as you can see the color is matching, both are white and it is looking beautiful now. So click on save and publish and cancel this. Now okay guys, now it is complete and it is really looking beautiful now. So we have completed the contact us page. Here in the demo website, as you can see below contact us website page, we have the newsletter and the icon box, so you can put that also. I have shown you how to put that in the home page section, so you can put that in the contact us page also. Fine. Now let's play with the footer. As you can see we have not done this one, the footer, so let's do this now. Come back to your dashboard, hover appearances and select widgets, and here you'll see something like footer area 1, footer area 2. To under footer area 1 we want text, so from here select text, here it is, and select footer area 1 and click on add widget, and again go to that link, and here you'll find a footer code, search for that. Here it is, footer area 1 CSS code. So just copy everything from here and paste it over here. Click on save. Fine. Now we have to understand this code. As you can see here, after image source there is a link. This is the link to this particular image. This image, as you can see, highway logo. So what you have to do is delete this link and put in the link of your own image, okay, over here. So that will change. Also, as you can see, we have the address over here. So from here you have to change the address. For example, here is the address, 81 Garden Road. So instead of this, you have to select this and delete it and put in anything like Mumbai Road or whatever, use your address. Then we have nitro@woorockets, the email address. So what you have to do is, instead of this nitro@woorockets.com, put in your own email address and make sure you make the same changes over here also. Fine. Then you have the phone number over here. So what you do is, instead of this phone number, delete it and put in your own phone number. Fine. Once you do that, everything will be fine. So let's save this. Okay, so we are done with the photo area one. Also, we have some social icons over here. So let's do this. Again, search for social icons. Here it is, Nitro Social. To select this one and select photo area one, click on add widget. Fine, you can select the icon color. For example, over here, as you can see, the icon color is green. So you can select any color. Fine. You can type in any title if you want. Once you're done that, click on save. Then we have some different links and tag clouds. So again, come to the widget and in the second footer area, let us add some tags. So here we have tag cloud. Select footer area 2, click on add widget. Okay, so we can put in any title if you want. For example, let's put tag cloud and click on save. Now let's put recent post in the third footer area. So select the third footer area. We want how many posts you want. For example, 3 posts. Click on save. Now in the fourth footer area, as you can see, we have some, you know, links, some different links. So we'll do that later. First, let's refresh the website and see how it looks like now. Okay guys, so as you can see, we are seeing this address and all. We cannot see the tags because we haven't created any tags. And for recent post, this is not looking good. So what we do is delete this recent post and we add some other one. We add Nitro recent post over there. That was with footer area 3. So click on add widget. Select categories to show. You can select multiple categories obviously. I'm selecting technology. Fine. Click on save. Now again, let's refresh and see the changes. Okay, now we can see the post over here. Fine. Now let's create the menu. As you can see, we have a menu over here. Okay, before that, let's change this copyright message. As you can see over here, the copyright message is different and we also have an image. So let's do that. Come over here. Click on customize. Now here you'll see something called footer. Select that. Come down, you have copyright text. Click on select content and again come back to that link and select this copyright code and paste it over here. Now click on save. Okay, so as you can see, now we see the changes over here. We have the image, we also have the copyright text. Now again click on set content, and as you can see, here is the date 2017. If you're watching this video or if you're in 2018, then you can change the date. Instead of Nitro theme tutorial, you can put in your name or your website name. So you can change all this text from here. You can change the link. Here is the link, AHREF. After that, it is linked to my YouTube channel, so you can change that link, and it is my name over here, Nayar Sheikh. So you can delete this and write in your name. Okay, fine. So this is how you do it. Now click on save, and after you're done with this, just cancel this. Now we have to create the menus for our header and also for this footer. So let's do that. Okay guys, so to create menus, come back to your dashboard, hover appearances, and select menu. Basically we have to create three different menus. One menu is for this one, as you can see, my account details. Next one is for this wish list and account, and the third menu is the main menu, as you can see over here, with mega menu. This is a mega menu, so we have to create three different menus. So just come back over here, click on create a new menu. Okay, so now let's create the footer menu first. So you can type in the name footer menu and click on create menu. Now what you have to do is go to your website, and after your website URL, type in /my-account/, okay, and hit enter. After you do that, you'll be redirected to this page. Make sure you stay tuned on this page. Now go to the menus, and from here select custom link, and in the URL copy this URL. Now right click on the dashboard and select copy link address, paste it over here. In the link text, type in my dashboard. Okay, click add to menu. Then again on the orders, clear, right click on the orders and copy link address, paste it over here, and in the link text type my orders, add to menu. Similarly for downloads, addresses and all this stuff, my address, add to menu. Okay, fine. So after you've done that, click on save menu. So this was our footer menu. Now let's again create a new menu. This will be our top menu, so let's name top menu. Click on create menu. We have wish list and my account for our top menu, so you'll find that over here. Wish list, fine. Click on add to menu, and for my account, as I told you, this is the link to my account, your website /my-account. So copy that address, paste it over here. In the link text, type in my account, add to menu. Fine. So this is your top menu. Again click on save menu. Now we have to create the main menu. As you can see, the main menu has mega menus, where that is, we can display the product on the menu. So we have to create this now. For that, again come back to your menus, click on create a new menu, name it as main menu, click on create menu. Now first we have home, so what we do is click on custom links enter the address, your website address over here. Fine. And in the link text, type in home. Click add to menus. The next one is sales, and it is a mega menu as you can see. So for that, what we do is in the URL, put in hashtag sign, just a hashtag sign, and type in sales over here. Now click add to menu. Now again put a hash sign and type in item 1. Let's see how many mega menus. See, as you can see in the mega menu, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different columns. So we have to create 5 different items. Similarly, again, asterisk sign, item 2. Asterisk sign. Item 3, item 4, and item 5. Now here what we have to do is drag all these items under sales, because they are sub menus of sales, so they should come over here. And in the sales, when you hover over sales, you will get this settings option. Click on settings and select enable mega menu. Okay, select the first one, 1x5, 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 full container. Fine. Now cancel this. Now select the item 1 and click on settings. Click disable column title and click on add element. Now click on product, because now what we have to do is add a product on the mega menu. As you can see, there are 4 different products added, so we have to add a product. So type in over here the name of the product. For example, we are typing iPhone 6s plus. Fine. Now cancel this. Item 2, add element, product. iPhone 6s lock, fine. So we have successfully added 4 products, as you can see. Now we have to add this thing, special offers, exclusive offers, or whatever you want to add. You can add any links over here. So let's do that. So for again, suppose you want to add some link, then you have to put the link in the URL. And suppose that is special offer, then type in special offer and click on add to menu. Okay, and all this thing will be under item 5. Whatever you're putting right now. Browse all, add to menu. Okay, so basically this is how you do it. Now after that, we have a blog page, contact us page. So what we do is go to pages, and we have blog page, contact us page. Select both these pages and click add to menu. So those 2 pages are added to the menu. Now make sure when you are working with the main menu, here you select the main menu from here. After you do that, just click on save menu. Okay, so we have successfully created all the 3 menus. Now what we have to do is enter or put all the 3 menus at their proper places. Let's first put the footer menu. So come back to your dashboard, hover over appearances and select widgets, custom menu. Just select this, and this time select footer area 4. Click on add widget, and from select menu we have to select the footer menu which we have created, and click on save. Now let's see how it looks like. Let's see our website. Let's scroll down. Okay, as you can see, now we have our menu over here. We can see all the three different points we have created. Now it's time to create the header. As you can see, we have not yet created the header, whereas in the demo website we have a very beautiful header. So let's create this header first. Again, come back to your dashboard, hover over Nitro. When you hover over Nitro, you get another option called header builder. Just click on header builder and just edit this header sample. Just click on edit. First we have to replace this logo with your logo, whatever logo you want. Okay, so just click on this, and from here select your logo. Just click on this to select your logo. Upload the image of your logo. Okay, this is my logo. Just click on open. Now click on select. You can also add a retina logo. A logo, just a bigger size logo. Fine. Again, click on select. Width should be 154. Okay. Go to spacing. Right padding should be 15 pixel. Fine. Rest all will be 10 pixels. That's fine. Now we have to change some settings, a container settings. So click over here. In the container setting, padding top and bottom should be 15 pixels, and left and right border should be 0 pixel. Make sure. And the row setting, padding top and bottom should be 15 pixels. Fine. And all the border should be 0 pixel. Whereas in the container setting, we don't want the padding, so you can delete that. We can delete this. Fine. So in row setting we have padding top and bottom 15 pixels, whereas in container we don't have that. Now we have to put this add over here. So for that, what we have to do is select this text and drag it over here. Fine. Now click over here, click on this. When we click on this text, we get this option, so we have to cancel this. Click on add menu, upload an image, select any ad if you want to add some ad. So suppose I want to add this ad, so select that and click on open. Now click on insert into post. Go to spacing. Right and leg padding will be 10, but up and down will be 0. So select 0, 0. Margin left will be 15 pixels. We also have to increase the size of this ad, so we can do this by just dragging this ad over here. Okay. Fine. Now we have to add the menu, as you can see over here. So we have the menu over here. Just select this, drag and drop over here. Now click on the menu, we get the option. So first we have to select the menu, top menu, text, hover color. You can select the hover color. Then in text setting, it should be Lato 400. That is fine. Font size should be 12 pixel. Height will be 14 pixel. letter spacing 0, fine. And this color is too dark, so it's all up to you which color you want. Item spacing should be 22. And in spacing, all the padding should be 10 pixels. Okay, make sure. Now we have to add the cart. So let's add that. So we have the cart. So drag this cart over here. Click on this cart. Now change the color, the price color and the hover color. It's all up to you, whatever color you want. Fine. Hover color also you can change it. Then you can change the icon from here. You can change the size of the icon obviously. Now we have to add another row. As you can see, we have another row for main menu. So from here, click on add row. Okay. Then again from top, drag the menu. Now this time over here. Now select this one. In the general setting, choose the main menu. Text, it should be. Hover text color, it's all up to you, whatever hover text color you want. Select that. Now come to text setting. It should be font weight should be 700. We want transform to be uppercase. Font size will be 11. Height will be 34. Spacing should be 1. Now coming to sub menu, here select the uppercase. Font weight will be 400, fine. Width will be 220. Font size should be 12. Rest everything is fine. Now come to spacing, and here we want margin as minus 25, and padding left and right will be 10, but top and bottom will be 0. So make sure that is done. You're fine. And after this, we have to add search bar, as you can see over here. So select search from here, drag it down. Here is our search bar. Now layout style, it should be boxed. As you can see, we want a box. Again, you can change the hover icon color and all this stuff over here. You can change the width of the text search. And make sure we enable live search. Okay guys, so we have successfully created our header also. Now let's update it. Now let's again come back to the website and refresh and see the changes. Okay, so as you can see, we are getting this header very small. We want a full size header. So again, come back to this and click on this add. Select this image. Okay, and now click on edit. And from here, size, select full size. Fine, now click on update. Again, click on update. It should solve the problem, hopefully. Now let's refresh the page and see. Okay, so as you can see, the problem is been solved now. Homepage and everything is looking fine now. Okay guys, now let's add this filter by price option. As you can see in the demo website, we have this option, filter by price. So now let's add that option in our website also. So for that, go to customize and select WooCommerce from this. Now select product category, and here it is, it shows sidebar layout. Select the second one, the third one, that is the right sidebar. And as you can see, the changes over here. Now we have a free space for sidebar so that we can add a filter option over here. Now click on save and publish. Okay, now cancel this. Now we have to add the filter option over here. So let's do that. Again, come back to your dashboard, hover appearances, select widgets. And here you see WooCommerce sidebar. First, we have to add the search option. So select this search and select the WooCommerce sidebar. Click on add widget. Fine. Then come to the bottom and you'll see something called WooCommerce product. So just select this one and make sure WooCommerce sidebar is selected. Again, click on add widget. Okay, click on save over here. On the search bar also, click on save. You can also add other sidebars like WooCommerce product categories. So you can also add this one. We also have WooCommerce product tags, WooCommerce product reviews, top rated products, you know, so you can WooCommerce recently viewed products. So you can add this also as your sidebar. So whenever you add it, make sure you save the thing over here. Recently viewed, make sure you save it over here. Now let's refresh the page and see the changes. Okay, so we can see the changes, but in the filter option we're not getting any option. So for that we have to do some settings. Again, come back to the dashboard. How are WooCommerce settings? And here we have product filter. So select product filter. And the first option is search by price. It is set to no. What we have to do is select as Woo range slider, the first option. Fine. So this is for price. And we also have to on the color option. Fine, but we are not getting any color option over here. So what we do is go to extensions and tick mark labels and color. Click on save changes. Now when we see this color option, we get a new option called color. Just select that one. Now select the additional options. Fine. First, let's save the changes. Okay, once we save these changes, we're getting a new option called toggle color terms. Just select that. And here, as you can see, it says black. So make sure black color is selected. Here it says blue. So make sure blue color is selected. Fine. Here it says gold, so we are selecting gold, whatever you like it. Fine, you can remove some color, it's all up to you. We want only three colors right now, so just three colors. You can also filter by memory. For example, if you are selling 128 GB, 64 GB products, then we can, you know, filter by these things also. After you do this, click on save changes. Then again, come back to our website and click on refresh. Now, as you can see, we are seeing the changes over here, and we can also filter the product according to this. As you can see, the product is getting filtered automatically when we change the price. So this is how we do the product filtration. Now let's see the in-stock alert feature. So again, for that, come back to your dashboard and select in-stock alert from here and select settings. First, we have to enable it. So click on enable. Put in your MailChimp username, API code and MailChimp list ID. For that, go to MailChimp.com. Log in to your account. Okay, so at the top you see something called profile, just click on that. Here is your username, so you can copy your username from here and paste it over here. And API code, you'll get it over here in the integration option. Just click on the integration option, sorry, the extras option, and here you'll see the API keys. Okay. So this is your API, just copy this. If you don't have an API, you can also create an API. Just click on this and you'll create an API. So just copy paste it over here, and here it asks for list ID. If you remember, we have created a list, so just go to lists and you can, you know, open any list. For example, let's open this list. Okay, so when you open this list, in the top URL bar you can see there is something called ID is equal to, so you just can copy that number and paste it over here. Fine. And you can check all this. This is the email your user will be getting. When, for example, it says we want to let you know that the product you interested is in stock. When the product is back in stock, this is the mail they will be getting. Okay, so click on save changes. So now when the any product is out of stock, they'll get the option, as I showed you earlier, they'll get the option to get an email when the product is back in stock. So we have enabled that option also. Now let's see the another option called share for discount. Then again go back to your dashboard, hover WooCommerce, select settings, and here you'll see something called share for discount. Just click on that, and we can enable the Facebook sharing, Twitter sharing, you know, Google Plus sharing. Just enter the Twitter name, sorry, real name here. You can you have to enter your app ID. It's really easy to get a Facebook app ID. Just click over here, log into your account, click over here, add a new app. You can, you know, put any name. For example, share for discount, make sure you have your own email address. You can select any category, click on create app ID and put this thing. Click on submit. Okay, now click on dashboard from here. This is your app ID. Just copy this and paste it over here and save changes. Now go to discount and you can enable product discount, cart discount, you know, coupon discount. For example, let's say product discount, individual type, mass type, it's all up to you. Suppose you want to give a 1% discount whenever someone shares your product on social media. Okay, so you can select which product you want to give discount on. For example, let's put in some name, iPhone. So we are giving discount on iPhone 6s Plus. Whenever the user shares our product on social media, he'll get a 1% discount, or you can obviously increase the percentage of discount, or you can put in a particular amount, so they'll get that discount. Again, click on save changes. Guys, after all the settings, what you have to do is go to your website, and after your website, you have to add a link /wp.admin that is given in the video description below. You can also see in the video, I have zoomed it, wp-admin/index.php?page is equal to wc-setup, and press enter. So once you do that and press enter, you'll get this option. So click on let's go. Okay, click on continue. And select your location. It's Maharashtra. Dollars, whatever it is, just select it. If you're charging tax, you can, you know, enter the prices. If you're, you know, shipping physical goods, make sure you tick mark this option. Now click on continue. For payment, we have already had this PayPal, so click on continue. Now we have settled that. Okay, fine. Now click on no thanks. Now everything is done. Now let's finalize the main settings of WooCommerce. So go to general, And here you have to select your base location. For example, I am in Maharashtra in India. So I'll select India, Maharashtra, and select where are you selling your to all the countries, to specific countries. So selling location, you have to select. If you want to enable taxes and calculations, you can enable this. You can change your currency from here. For example, you can select dollars, US dollars from here. Fine. After you've done that, click on save changes. Now let's come to products, click on products. You can change the weight unit from kilogram to gram or anything else, from centimeter to millimeter, meter in the dimension unit, and you can save changes. Now come to shipping. So we can have many. For example, I am selling only in India. So what I do is I click over here, add a shipping zone. Okay, zone name I put in India. I'm sorry, India. So select the region. For example, I'm selecting India. Now click on save changes. Okay, once I have entered the shipping zone, next what I have to do is click on India over here. And I can add a shipping method. Just click on shipping method. You can add a flat rate, free shipping, local pickup. For example, I want to add a flat rate. Okay, so I can add a flat rate. Now I can go to settings and change what is the rate I want to it. For example, I want $10 flat rate for shipping cost. Then I can do that. Just click on save changes. You can also offer free shipping. Okay, so click on add shipping method. You can add free shipping. Click on add. Now let's come to checkout. In checkout options, we can also use coupon for discount. Subsequently, you can use coupons. Fine. So just tick mark over here and click on save changes. And under WooCommerce, you see an option called coupons. Open that link in a new tab. And as you can see, we can add new coupons. For example, let's see an example. Click on add coupon. Now we can add the coupon name. For example, let's say 10 off. We can add a description. Get a 10% discount. Fine. Card discount, product discount. So suppose I'm putting card discount. So whenever anyone puts put this coupon code while checkout, they will get some amount of discount. Fine. So I'm putting, for example, $10, a 10% discount. So they'll get 10% discount when they use my coupon code. I can also have an expiry date for that coupon. Fine. I can also limit the number of time that coupon code can be used by single person, or in general the number of time the coupon code can be used. So that is a lot of options you get for that. Also you can click on publish. Now anyone using this coupon code can get a 10% discount. Okay, so this is how it works. Now we have to add a payment method, and we obviously prefer the PayPal method. So PayPal is automatically selected. Just click on PayPal. Make sure PayPal is enabled. And there are three options: username, password, and signature. You'll get it on your PayPal account. Just open your PayPal account. Logging to paypal.com. Once you do that, scroll down, you'll see something called seller preferences over here. Click on that. Here we have something called API access. Just click on update over here. There are two options which says, for me it says view API signature, for you it might say create API signature. So once you click on here, you'll get all the API information. So what you have to do is just copy and paste all those information over here. You'll get your username is obviously your username, and password and signature you'll get it from there. Once you click on over here, view API signature, you'll get your password and a signature from there. So you can put that and paste it over here, and after that click on save changes. Then go to accounts and make sure enable registration on the my page account is enabled. That is very important. And after that click on save changes. Let's also add the buy now button. So for that just click on customize, select WooCommerce, general settings, and enable buy now button. Here we have. Okay, after that click on save and publish. Now cancel this. Now once you're done that, let's see whether we are able to do a transaction, buy something from the store or not. We already have one product in the cart, so click on checkout now. Okay, so we are redirected to the checkout page. Let's enter some name. Email address, number, one, two, put any number. Okay, any address. Okay, let's see whether our coupon code works or not. Click on apply coupon. So as you can see, we are getting a 1% discount. Fine, and PayPal is selected. Click on proceed to PayPal. Okay, so we can enter through PayPal, or we can also pay with debit or credit card. Well, guys, so this is the end of this video. I hope you guys like this video. If you guys like this video, then do subscribe to my channel and also give a thumbs up to this video. Thank you for watching.